As internet finally starts to mature, people begin to realize how important online security and privacy really are. One of the most effective tools for security on the web is NoScript extension for Firefox. NoScript was built to block execution of JavaScript by your web browser in order to prevent infiltration by malware, trackers, and annoying ads. JavaScript, unfortunately, is still most frequent code used by web developers to deliver content and run websites. So if you want to experience the web fully, you'll need to know how to operate NoScript to get the most out of it. The trade-offs are absolutely worth it. For little inconvenience, you get a tremendous amount of security. NoScript will act as a local firewall for your web browser, blocking malicious attacks before they get a chance to get inside your system. The best way to learn is on the go, so let's get started. You can install NoScript the same way you would install any add-in for Firefox. When you first run it, this is what you're gonna see. For purposes of this tutorial, we're going to test it on Reddit to see what it does. When you load the website, a couple of things will happen by default. First, NoScript is going to notify you about the number of blocked items. When you open the menu, you'll see that all three domains are set to default trust level. By default, NoScript doesn't trust these domains very much and blocks all JavaScript. So let's see how this affected the website. You see that NoScript prevented a lot of content from loading, and it also blocked an apparent advertisement. But we want to use Reddit, so let's see what we can do. Open the menu by clicking on the NoScript icon again, and you'll notice there is a faded blue S with a little clock icon, so let's click that. When you close the menu, NoScript will automatically reload the page with scripts enabled for the trusted domain. As you can tell, we still can't see much media, so let's temporarily trust some other domains. Click temporarily trusted for redditmedia.com and redditstatic.com. Now things start to look very different. You can see that upon allowing these domains to execute JavaScript, a bunch of other stuff wants to make its way through your browser, but NoScript blocks them by default until you specifically allow them through the previous process. And this is how NoScript protects you. It lets you be in control of what content websites execute and thus protects your online privacy and security as well. However, we only temporarily trusted Reddit, so that means if you close and restart your browser, NoScript will not remember your preferences. This has a quick fix. Open the menu and click on the trusted icon to make your trusted level permanent. Now, each time you go to Reddit, it will load with all media content. And while we are here, we can actually see that some JavaScripts want to track us and load some advertisements. By default, NoScript will only block JavaScript, but other content might have sneaked in. To make sure NoScript blocks every request from these domains, we are going to set our trust levels to untrusted. And I can already tell you that you definitely don't need Google Tag Services, Google Tag Manager, and Amazon Ad System to enjoy Reddit. These are trackers and advertisers that just want to sell your browsing history and preferences to the highest bidder. NoScript offers some options under the hood. You can access them by clicking the third icon on the top left bar of the menu. This will show you how NoScript functions in the default settings. Leave the option Disable Restrictions Globally unchecked, because otherwise you would basically turn NoScript off. If you want to allow scripts for top-level domains, you can tell NoScript to trust them by default by checking the box for temporarily set top-level sites to trusted. But if privacy is your main concern, I would recommend against that. Below this, you can see what types of content NoScript is capable of blocking. Since you installed NoScript to boost your privacy, I would recommend to uncheck all the options in the default section. This will give you maximum security, as your default trust level will block everything. In the Per Site Permission tab, NoScript saves all of your trust levels for a record. The green lock icon, as you can notice, means that it will trust only encrypted HTTPS content, and anything that's not secured will be blocked. That's very useful at preventing malicious scripts from executing on websites you visit. You see that NoScript comes preloaded with some whitelist. I personally don't like this, and I always set all these websites to untrusted unless I decide otherwise. This whitelist was put in place to make NoScript more usable and convenient for less tech-savvy users. You can tweak your appearance a little bit if you want to, and you can leave the advanced options as they are. Back to the menu, there are a couple of things you can do to play around. NoScript gives you an option to choose what type of content to allow to make the website functional, instead of just allowing or blocking everything from each domain. This option is in the fourth trust level called Custom. Custom trust level sets specific content to trusted, and NoScript will remember your choices. It will even give you some hints on what to allow to make a website functional. If you want to test what you can allow and block on a domain, you can set custom level to temporarily trusted by clicking the little clock icon at the bottom right bar of the custom column. Because many scripts are loading in a cascading order, that is, allowing script A will load script B and so on, which could not have been visible before, you might need to repeatedly go back to the custom level and allow some more stuff to get proper functionality. The best thing is that you only need to go through this process once and NoScript will remember it. In return, you get back much of your online privacy and security in just a few clicks. In this mode, NoScript will block autoplay media and will give you a click-to-play option. If you don't want to do that, you can always just find the content to allow in the custom level or just set the whole domain to trusted or temporarily trusted. If you don't have time to pinpoint specific content to make a website functional, NoScript lets you temporarily allow all scripts to load on the page with a single click on the clock icon with a red exclamation point in the top right corner of the menu bar. To revert all temporarily trusted choices, just click the last clock icon in the very right to revoke all temporary permissions. If you are really in a hurry, you can disable restrictions for the tab you are currently on, which will allow scripts from all cascading domains to load in one click. To revert it, just click the tab icon with a red exclamation point again to enable NoScript restrictions. At the point of making this video, NoScript is not capable of blocking scripts as third party while allowing them as first party at the same time. For example, you might want to block Facebook social media plugins that track your browsing history. This is when Facebook runs as a third party domain on other websites. But when you visit Facebook directly, you want it to run flawlessly. That's when Facebook runs as a first-party domain. To do that, you need extensions like Umatrix or uBlock Origin. Luckily, I have tutorials for both of them on my channel, so feel free to check them out. If you found this tutorial helpful, you might want to share it on your platforms of choice or show it to your friends. The more people protect their privacy, the more your privacy is protected as well. So spread this message and subscribe to my channel to find out more about how you can stand up for digital rights. Thanks for watching.